Okay, it's time to go. Go get him.
Ready. The excitement levels are, I mean, you can be as in control as you can be, but there's still that, because it's just like, we've never done that.
Just being on stage with Ted is electric. Almost like a first date. She smells good. She looks good. She has an essence about her, but you're wondering. I wonder what happens as we move through the night.
It kicked ass. People just definitely got into it. Sebastian knows how to work a crowd.
I do this and the way I move around. It's not like a boy band. There's not a synchronized jumping up and down and whoa. It's a different beast. You have to adapt to your situation. That's part of the gig.
It was going to be packed with true fans of rock and metal.
This one is for all the youth!
It's just not about the haircut. I don't give a about the jewelry and getting my nails done, and I appreciate everybody's input, but it's about singing.
Become us from the child, spend our lives a trial, walking an endless mile. We are the
youth. I thought that they all played well, they all looked well. I thought it sounded pretty good for the first time that they were together.
After this as a band, if we do continue to write songs, if we do make a record, it all came from this crazy experiment, and I'd be glad for it to go on. I don't want to go home.
Punishment was the tightest song on the show. That's when I suddenly felt, you know what, this is going to be good.
We played Punishment, people started going nuts. I'm
really pleased how wrong I was with my stereotype of Biohazard. It's about putting forth your best effort.
All I was really concerned with was nailing out on the tiles. It's all super important.
This one is for the old man. This one's for Bonzo. He came up with a song. He goes something like this.
Talk about my dad at home. Now I miss him. You know, there's a big part of my life that I miss. I talk about him as if it's like he never went away. It's like as if he did this together and he did that. And all I'm doing is referring to stories what people have told me. You know, I just think of him as being my dad and always being the cool dad. I use him as kind of as a reference point. So I go, oh, what would Dad have done? Because one, he taught me. Two, I don't know many better drummers.
Sebastian was throwing t-shirts out during Ted's guitar solo.
Sebastian made a criminal misjudgment by daring to f*** with my guitar masterpiece. Played it as a masterpiece, but it was very, very distracting and unprofessional.
Both of us just zoned in on each other. Down the neck, went doing the big slide. But in my brain, I was an 11-year-old kid running around my room playing air guitar to Ted Nugent.
Defining moment for me was coming up with the song Take It Back. That's what will last when we're all gone. It's gonna be that song.
Hey, baby, to take it back.
It was amazing. We want to present Democracy as a true supergroup. You know, five superpowers of rock that came together to make magic. Sebastian can't touch alcohol. He just can't touch it.
I couldn't believe it. I was just like, man, how long until somebody punches this guy's lights in?
You guys like to drink a little Jack down in Las Vegas? What do you think? Should I take a sip?
Yeah!
Who wants to deal with behavior like that? I know why he's not at Skid Row anymore.
You might like to get back there today!
Ted Nugent's face when I came out of that jet, he's going,
what do you think? Should I take it?
I went like this, come on, Sin City, what are you doing? Uh-huh. No, even the joke. Hello.
I know goat piss when I taste it. This one's for you, Las Vegas.
I saw Evan's face, and I actually walked up to Evan, and I was like, nice piss.
I would have kneecapped his ass.
I was like, after all that, Ted, man. Can you imagine if that was real? What a nightmare, right?
No, come on.
I'm a training professional.
I don't.
to have the talent on the stage of Damocracy, that's something that never comes around in a lifetime.
I'm absolutely blown away by the talent of these guys, and just in a genre that I just wasn't that familiar with personally.
You know him, you love him, you want to bear his children. Mr. Terrible, Ted Nugent! Oh, and by the way, speaking of the American dream, I give you my lead singer, that Damocracy zombie, Mr. Sebastian.
I thought it was a gangbuster, baby. I thought it was a rock out. I thought it was an all-American musical orgy of spirit, attitude, piss and vinegar, fire, and get down.
I'm so close to perfect, it was stupid.
I'm sure it rivals the building of the Hoover Dam or the Transcontinental Railroad, and I'm serious about that.
Rock on three, one, two, three, rock!